In this video, I'll be going to discuss Schottky barrier diode, how Schottky barrier diode works, what are the advantages and disadvantages which is there with Schottky barrier diode. So let us begin. First of all, what is the symbol of Schottky barrier diode? So Schottky barrier diode, that is a two terminal device, and its symbol is this, where this is anode and this is cathode. So this is the basic symbol which is there with Schottky barrier diode. Now what is there with its internal structure? So let us try to understand what is there with its internal structure. Now the designing of internal structure with Schottky barrier diode that is to remove depletion region. So when we see Schottky barrier diode structure, then in its structure metal is getting combined with semiconductor material, so that is unipolar device where this is metal. And this is n-type material. So we can say this is what anode and this is cathode, where in its internal structure we have metal at one side and we have n-type material at other side. So when we diffuse metal with n-type material, at that time it is unipolar device, so there will be no depletion region. So as it is not having depletion region, it is unipolar device, so there will be only electrons as a majority carrier. So due to it is unipolar device, it has electrons as majority charge carrier. So ultimately here we can say this Schottky barrier diode, that is only having one semiconductor layer and that is connected with metal. Now in metal we can use gold or high conductive material. So usually it have been used with gold. Now when we talk about some other cases which is what associated with this Schottky barrier diode, that is it is having very less reverse recovery time. It has very less reverse recovery time. So it has very less reverse recovery time, and because of very less reverse recovery time we can use this Schottky barrier diode in fast switching devices like in microwave. Now why it is having very less reverse recovery time? So when we talk about PN junction, at that time there will be P-type material and n-type material that is getting diffused together, and when it is being diffused together there will be space charge region. So because of it has space charge region, what happens is when we keep this PN junction diode in forward bias, it conducts from P-type material to N-type material, and during its conduction holes of P-type materials, that is getting transferred to N-type material, and electrons of N-type material, that is getting transferred to P-type material. But when we switch it from on to off, those holes which have moved to n-type material, and those electrons that have moved towards p-type material requires time to have transition from one side to other side. So it takes time to turn it off. So that time is called as reverse recovery time. Now when we talk about Schottky barrier diode, it does not have any space charge region. So when we turn it on, so there will be a flow of electrons because of majority carrier is electrons here. And when we reverse bias this, at that time there is no space charge region, so there is no extra efforts required to have motion of charge carrier. So that's why we can say it has very less reverse recovery time, and due to it very less reverse recovery time, it can be very useful in fast switching devices. So see, that is what the basic case which is there with this. Now let us try to understand what will be VI characteristic of Schottky barrier diode, and we will be observing what is the difference in between that. So here I have shown V voltage and over here that is current. So let us see what is there with PN junction diode's characteristic, and then we will be observing what is there with Schottky barrier diode's characteristic. So in PN junction diode's characteristic, we all know current will start to conduct after potential barrier voltage, and shape will be something this, where this voltage that will be 0.7 voltage in case of silicon diode, and this voltage will be 0.3 voltage in case of germanium diode. And in reverse bias, very minor current is flowing, and after breakdown current will flow. So this is the characteristic which is there with PN junction, where we can say current in reverse bias, that is there in terms of microampere, and current in forward bias, that is there in terms of milliampere. Now let us have a characteristic of Schottky barrier diode. So if we see the characteristic of Schottky barrier diode, so that is similar to this, but forward voltage that will be less, that is there in terms of 0.2 to 0.25 voltage. So that is what the forward voltage which is there over here. And in reverse bias even, there will be shape which is like this. So this is how characteristic is difference. So this is a characteristic of Schottky barrier diode. Now there are so many things which we need to understand based on this characteristic. When we use this characteristic at that time, what happens is, like when we use PN junction in forward bias, at that time it is having forward voltage drop, and when we have Schottky barrier diode, at that time it does not have any, that it is having forward voltage drop, but it is not having that much forward voltage drop as it is there with PN junction diode. So there are some cases which is what we need to understand. Like let us have PN junction diode, and if I say I use this in forward bias by keeping anode positive with respect to cathode, and if I say forward voltage is 0.7 voltage and current pass through this that is equals to 1 ampere, then in time t is equals to 1 minute means 60 second, amount of energy dissipated, that is energy is equals to power into time, and power is VI t, so that will be 0.7 into 1 into 60, so that is around 42 joule. So 42 joule energy in single minute, that is getting dissipated as heat. So heat energy that is getting dissipated as this configuration, which is what I have shown over here. While if we use Schottky barrier diode, so in that, if I keep this in forward bias, and if forward voltage, that is 0.2 voltage, and current flowing through this is 1 ampere. And if I do this experiment for 1 minute in 60 seconds, then energy that will be VIT, and that is 0.2 into 1 into 60, so that will be around 12 joule. So see the basic difference, like say energy dissipated as heat in this case, that will be 12 joule, while as if we use this normal PN junction diode, then energy dissipation that will be 42 joule. So that is how forward drop voltage that is affecting to the performance of any circuit. Now let us try to understand what are the other advantages which could be utilized. So as we were been discussing, Schottky barrier diode is having no depletion region, and because of it does not have any depletion region, it's having very less reverse recovery time, that leads to use of Schottky barrier diode in fast switching applications. So if I use diode as it is shown in this circuit, where this is AC supply, and let us say this is 5 voltage and 50 hertz AC. In that case, across load resistance, even if diode is there or Schottky barrier diode is there, you will be observing waveform that will be this. So this will be the basic waveform, which is what we can observe. Now, as if I increase frequency to 1 gigahertz, as if I increase frequency to 1 gigahertz, then for both of the diode are having different performance. Now let us try to see what is those different performance. So in case of 1 gigahertz, if I say this is the graph which is there with Schottky barrier, so in that case graph will be this only, it will not getting affected that much. The reason is it is having very fast switching. But as if we talk about a graph which is associated with PN junction, so that will changes to see, that is how there will be a change. So here, because of reverse recovery time is more, this is what the noise, or we can say disturbance, that is happening in normal PN junction diode. So that's why we don't use normal PN junction diode in fast switching circuit. So this is what the case which is there with normal PN junction diode. Now let us have one more case where we find PN junction diode is having some disadvantage. It is not like Schottky barrier diode is having all those advantages which is there over normal PN junction diode. There are some disadvantages which is there with SBD. So what are those disadvantages? So there is a flow of reverse current when we talk about SPD. So let us try to understand that by example. Like see, for example, if I have a normal diode which has been kept in forward bias like this, and if I have SPD which have been kept in forward bias, as we can see, so in that case usual conventional current direction, that should be this. So usual current direction, that is this. But it is not only current is flowing in this direction, there is a flow of reverse current. So this is called as reverse current. But when we talk about this reverse current, then in normal PN junction diode, this reverse current that is there in terms of 1, 2, 2 microampere. While we talk about SPD, so in that case this reverse current that is there in terms of 70 to 200 microampere. So this is one basic disadvantage, which is what resulting into SPD should not be used in all the cases. So few more things which is even there which we need to think about when we use SPD. So if we have more reverse current flowing through the diode, in some applications like peak detector circuit we cannot use SPD. The reason is, in peak detector circuit if reverse current is flowing, that may damage the circuit. Now let us have few more examples where we should not use SPD. So one more example which I am giving, which is what peak inverse voltage. So what is peak inverse voltage first of all? So peak inverse voltage, that is a maximum reverse bias voltage. So if I connect diode in reverse bias, as you can see the case which is there with SPD and normal PN. So this is SPD where we are connecting this diode in reverse bias, and here even in PN junction diode we are connecting diode in reverse bias. So up to what maximum voltage it sustains, that is what peak inverse voltage. That is what peak inverse voltage. So up to what maximum value this diodes can sustain. So that is what we can easily see, that from this characteristic where peak inverse voltage, that is up to this in normal PN junction diode, while it is less in SPD. So what happens is, when we use this kind of diode in circuit, and if less PN voltage, peak inverse voltage is there, in that case it may damage the circuit. So for low power application and low power fast switching application, we should use Schottky barrier diode, and for low frequency high power applications we should use PN junction diode. So if we say, like, where should be the application of normal PN, so normal PN should be used at high power low frequency applications. And when we talk about SPD, then SPD, Schottky barrier diode, that should be used at low power and high frequency applications. So that is how we should be able to understand how SPD is working. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, then please subscribe to my channel, and if any query is there, then place that below in comment so that I can be able to help you out for those queries. Thank you so much, Purvanchi.